Black Holes and Revelations. Gravitational Wave Background. Famous rock band Muse was definitely onto something in 2006 with their album Black Holes and Revelations. I would definitely recommend you give it a listen. But before you do, let's see what the universe has been hiding from us. We keep looking for ways to build time machines, but turns out they have been there all along. As time passes and technology grows, we discover new ways to see through time, which is an incredible opportunity given to us. One such intriguing concept is gravitational waves, ripples in the fabric of space-time caused by the movement of massive objects. These waves were first predicted by Albert Einstein in his theory of general relativity over a century ago, but remained elusive until very recently. In a groundbreaking discovery, scientists detected the faint echoes of a gravitational wave background, ushering in a new era of astronomy and unveiling a previously hidden aspect of the universe. If this background exists, it challenges what we know about the hierarchical formation of the universe, as mergers of massive objects would have happened so early on, meaning that they existed so early on. Without their existence, we would indeed have remained absolutely clueless. We will see how quasars helped us find the cosmic microwave background, and how pulsars showed us something we could have never dreamt of finding. Quasars. What are they? Quasars, short for quasi-stellar radio source, are incredibly bright and distant objects found at the far reaches of the cosmos. They were first discovered in the 1960s, and their true nature remained a puzzle for many years. At first, astronomers believed they were stars due to their point-like appearance. But as technology advanced, these luminous objects finally revealed their true identity. These beacons of light are found at the centers of active galaxies, surrounded by swirling disks of very heated gases and dust. Behind every quasar, a black hole is found, a monstrous gravitational force that devours anything that strays too close. As matter plunges into the black hole, it forms an accretion disk, a swirling, chaotic storm that releases tremendous amounts of energy in the form of radiation. This radiation is what makes quasars shine so phenomenally bright. In fact, they are among the most luminous objects in the entire universe, outshining entire galaxies like the Milky Way, which contains over 400 billion stars. That's only the energy emitted by a single one of the quasars. But what truly sets them apart is their crazy distances from us. They exist in the faraway reaches of space and time, billions of light years away from Earth. The light we see from a quasar today actually left its source billions of years ago, giving us a glimpse into the ancient universe. It's like looking through a time machine, observing the universe as it once was. And as astronomers continue to study quasars, they uncover a multitude of fascinating phenomena. Some quasars exhibit redshift, a phenomenon caused by the expansion of the universe, which stretches the light waves, shifting them towards the red end of the spectrum. This redshift provides crucial clues about the universe's expansion rate and cosmological history. Pulsars. What are they? It is easy to confuse quasars and pulsars, but they're actually different types of objects in the universe. Pulsars are one of the most intriguing astronomical phenomena out there. And trust me, the universe has no shortage of wonders. They are the remnants of massive stars that have gone supernova. When these titanic explosions occur, the core of the star collapses under its own gravity, forming a neutron star. Now picture this. A neutron star the size of a city, packing more mass than our Sun into an itty-bitty space. These dense objects are like the cosmic equivalent of a black hole's overachieving little sibling. But here's where it gets really mind-boggling. Pulsars have magnetic fields that put even the most powerful magnet you've ever encountered to shame. Now let's get into why these cosmic lighthouses are called pulsars. As the neutron star spins on its axis, its powerful magnetic field causes beams of electromagnetic radiation to shoot out from its magnetic poles. Just like a lighthouse beam slicing through the darkness, these beams sweep across the cosmos with unparalleled precision. The mind-blowing part is that as the beams of radiation sweep towards us, they appear as regular pulses of energy. It's like the universe's very own Morse code, beaming messages from the depths of space. These pulses can be as predictable as your favorite morning routine or as erratic as your cat chasing a laser pointer. But no matter what, they never fail to captivate our imaginations. We're talking hundreds of rotations per second. Others take their time, lazily completing a rotation over the course of several seconds or even minutes. Quasars and the cosmic microwave background. But quasars have another intriguing feature that has recently caught the attention of astronomers: their ability to measure the new background of the universe. The background of the universe corresponds to the glow of radiation left over from the Big Bang, known as the cosmic microwave background, CMB. This radiation is uniform and fills all of space, providing a snapshot of the early universe when it was just 380,000 years old. This is where quasars come in. Due to their extreme brightness in distant locations, quasars can act as backlights and shine their light through the intergalactic medium, the vast expanse of gas and dust that fills the space between galaxies. As this light traverses the intergalactic medium, it interacts with the gas, leaving behind subtle imprints on its spectrum. These imprints, known as absorption lines, reveal such valuable information about the properties of the gas, such as its temperature and density. By analyzing the absorption lines in quasar spectra, astronomers can map out the distribution and evolution of gas in the universe, providing insights into the formation of galaxies and the interplay between galaxies and their surrounding environments. But what makes quasars particularly useful for measuring the new background of the universe is their ability to probe a specific period in cosmic history. Quasars exist in the epoch known as the Cosmic Dawn, a time when the first galaxies were forming and the universe was transitioning from a neutral state to one filled with ionized gas. During this Cosmic Dawn, the universe was undergoing a major transformation, and the radiation from quasars was interacting with the neutral hydrogen gas, causing it to become ionized. By studying the absorption lines from quasars, we can precisely measure when and how this ionization process occurred and track the growth of galaxies and the buildup of intergalactic gas over cosmic time. Quasars are like time machines that let astronomers see into the early days of the universe. By studying the different types of gases in quasars, scientists can figure out how much hydrogen gas there was at different times and how it changed over time. This helps us understand how galaxies were formed. Pulsars and the gravitational wave background. As fascinating as quasars are and how much they have helped us figure out our origins, the smaller pulsars are just as useful. Thanks to them, astronomers have made a groundbreaking discovery in science. We finally heard the cosmic symphony of gravitational waves resonating throughout the universe. After years of searching, scientists have detected the low-pitch hum of these waves, referred to as the gravitational wave background. This background is believed to be the leftover echoes from the events that happened soon after the Big Bang and the merging of the supermassive black holes across the universe. This will provide us with a lot of useful information about how our universe formed and if collisions of supermassive black holes were catalysts of structure formation. The discovery was announced by teams of scientists from around the world in a highly anticipated and coordinated effort. The signals were found to be consistent with the presence of the most massive black holes in the entire universe, giants weighing billions of suns. While the exact cause of the hum is still unknown, this discovery provides compelling evidence for the existence of gravitational waves. Let's look into how pulsars revealed this to us. It really was not trivial. The science community decided to start observing millisecond pulsars for a period of 15 years. Millisecond pulsars are the ones that rotate at extremely high speeds, where the frequency of rotation is at the order of milliseconds, creating the perfect natural chronometer for working with precision. In observing pulsars for such a long time, we are able to detect the tiniest deviations of the time their light needs to reach us because of how precise it is. This is called pulsar timing. Before continuing, let me give you some useful information to get you through this video. When gravitational waves cross space-time, they stretch and squeeze it, which means that the trajectory of light, also called geodesic, will bend as the gravitational wave is passing it. This bending will make light take longer time to reach because its path is no longer straight. In fact, that is exactly what astronomers observe from pulsars, the time their light theoretically needed to reach us in absence of any deviation caused by gravitational waves was shorter than seen. And for all the time of observation, which helped them conclude that those gravitational waves are in fact a constant background and not a single observed collision between massive objects like they are used to detect. In this graph, we see that the findings of a gravitational wave background are supported by analyzing the variations in the arrival times of 67 pulsars, resulting in a total of 2,211 different pairs. The anticipated correlation patterns between these pairs, based on the influence of passing gravitational waves, are represented by the dashed line. On the other hand, the solid line illustrates the expected correlations in the absence of the background. The nanograv's measurements, depicted as blue data points, demonstrate the anticipated rise in correlation for both small and large separations, indicative of the presence of a gravitational wave background signal. The frequency of this background is very low, leading to the theory that their collisions were caused by the merging of small black holes, neutron stars, their masses being smaller than a couple hundred solar masses. Possible theories. Astronomers have found potential black hole couples using different types of telescopes, but now they have a new tool, these famous gravitational waves. These waves can point them in the right direction to search for electromagnetic waves and study black hole pairs in detail. Chung-Pei Ma, a leading professor of astronomy and cosmology, is leading a project to study the 100 closest supermassive black holes to Earth. Her goal is mainly to find signs of activity that suggest a binary pair. Nanograv will then focus its pulsar timing array on that area of the sky to look for gravitational waves. These waves are emitted by black hole binaries for millions of years before they merge. There are other possible explanations for the background gravitational waves, like dark matter accidents, primordial black holes, and cosmic strings. However, the researchers believe that black hole pairs are the most likely cause. To prove this, they need to measure how much the gravitational wave signals vary across the sky. Binaries should produce much bigger variations compared to other sources. This is where the real work and excitement begin. The team is working hard to improve their measurements and gain better insights into the populations of early supermassive black hole binaries. And that brings us to the end of our journey. From quasars to pulsars, we've explored the amazing ways these objects have helped us unravel the mysteries of the universe. It's like a never-ending game of cosmic hide-and-seek, where each discovery leads to even more questions. But hey, that's what keeps us scientists on our toes, constantly pushing the boundaries of knowledge. So until the next mind-boggling discovery, keep looking up at the sky and keep dreaming big. Who knows what other cosmic wonders are waiting to be found? Stay curious, stay nerdy, and keep exploring the infinite cosmic playground that is our universe. See you next time. Thanks for watching. We'll see you in the next video, where we'll explore more fascinating developments of our universe. Don't forget to like, subscribe to our channel to stay tuned with our latest videos and most exciting subjects.